Hello and welcome back to Star Trek Birth of the Federation. And when we last left off, we finally made some headway against the Ferengi Alliance and essentially demolished their military, leaving their planets and colonies at our complete mercy, at least to a certain extent, because some of them are heavily defended. And they also control at least three minor races with very substantial system-wide defenses, including the all-important orbital batteries. And it will be quite some time until we can tackle them. And also second objective, we also have to defend our allies, the Federation, against a second Borg cube, even the third one. I kind of lost track of them, to be honest. But I do remember that we destroyed at least the two last episodes, and but we have our ships incoming to the third one, which is somewhere near Sol, if maybe Sol. So first things first, let's reset our overlays here to something a little more useful. And yes, we also made contact with the Cardassian Union finally, and they hate our guts since they want us gone quite badly. But we, by comparison, well, we don't have any beef with them in particular. And the Romulans we haven't discovered yet, and it may be the case that the Borg have finished this objective for us already, since they started out in the middle of the map someplace. And this was the highest concentration of the Borg cubes, at least initially. And yeah, so the Federation is recovering at a snail pace from the first Borg incursion on their home system, which we fended off with our ships. And when we have another Borg cube here getting to work on the most important colony they have left, I think it would be fair to say it's fully colonized and fully terraformed. And yeah, I think that's, well, maybe we can get over there in time before all the people are down there are eradicated. And thankfully we managed to save this colony with 2 million people left, yeah. So 5 turns, and I think it will be just here, narrowing down to the threshold, and hopefully we can manage. And as you can see, the orbital batteries do absolutely nothing against this thing. I don't think it's even, still full hit points. No shields on the Borg, of course, and thanks to all ships having been upgraded with our research, or because of our research, we should have an easier time with them without losing too many light ships in the process. That would be swell. And wow, that's a good idea here, trying to set up a new colony. But all these other systems, of course, they are barren, completely uninhabitable. I mean, technically they still are, but they won't be very productive. So we are looking at, this used to be a class M planet, for instance, with probably a population cap of 120 on its own. And now what we're looking at here is not particularly appealing, to be honest. Yeah, 25, 0.1, it takes ages to terraform these things now. It's kinda sad, yeah, especially for the Federation, because they used to be the second most powerful empire in the galaxy, yeah. And not so much anymore. And over here we have a destroyer too, which is interesting, because that means the Cardassians must be lagging behind in the research department. Very intriguing, so hopefully we don't have to worry about them as much, but they will be bringing their intelligence arm to bear against us, which is also why I did away with the espionage approach, which did not give us anything, really. We had exactly 2 successes, and both of them weren't exactly useful information, to be honest. Yeah, holo cinema, who cares, really? But as a reminder, we're swinging around with some of the ships, and actually I don't think I took care of anything in particular. Yeah, so these are all of our Bird of Prey here getting destroyed in Ferengi space. And we also have to tend to our systems here and move some ships around before we can go to the next turn. Okay, then this was a minor system. We are building this up with mixed facilities, as it would seem. I think now that we have made contact with the Cardassians, that will be even more important than before. Okay, skip a couple of buildings here. And we could build more heavy ships, do we need to, or do we want to for that matter, because we are outpacing our, as you can see, our ship support cost already. We could use more assault transporters, I suppose, instead of heavy warships, so I think we get started on this again. Yeah, only 2 turns, that's much better than on the other systems, so maybe just the switch to round. Yeah, so this one can be in the queue order still, and then we pump out some heavy Bird of Prey, perhaps. Or just some basic ones, a couple of raiding parties here. Toon Toto should be plentiful against the Cardassians for right now, and we can also see what happened to the Romulan Star Empire and whether or not there's actually anything left of them, because they're also our arch rivals, yeah, together with the Ferengi. And we have to take over or obliterate every single system, no exceptions, and including the minor races, assuming we don't want to sway them with money, you know. But I don't think we can afford this really with our military and our economy being rather weak still. I mean, we are making some progress here, Grant, but still, it's not fantastic. So the lithium factory, or refinery, I should say. And 415, that's a no-brainer here for an industrial base. means you should also set up a shipyard here. And the mining prison probably, together with the Hall of Warriors here to offset the morale penalty. Alright. Anything else? Yeah, we only have to move the ships around and we are converging on our border, which is completely underdeveloped. We have a starbase here, which is not particularly useful because of the X-Wave poser nearby. And there are some undiscovered systems, but alright, and we also wanted to connect these Verbs finder here, allowing our medium range ships here to pass through, but apparently it's just one turn off, and even with the starbase and the shipyard, we were unable to make this happen. And yeah, there's also some minor ships remaining here from one of the, I think it was the Talarians here, yeah, who actually broke diplomatic contact with us after signing an affiliation treaty. Okay then, I think we support our starbase for now. Do we need them on the other side of the wormhole right now? I mean, we could replace some of these minor ships, I suppose. Okay, well, we'll see what happens here. It will depend on what the Cardassians decide to do. And when they will declare war on us, which won't take very long, I think. And the intelligence arm will swing in action here real soon, of course. A heavy cruiser, okay. We can get some scouting going here, hopefully set up a couple more colonies, if for nothing else, than to have another advanced outpost there with a subspace scanner and things of that nature. Yeah, I think we could, we don't want to lose any ships ideally, so we can bring them over via brief here together with the other battle cruiser, and then we can support our attack on the Borg cube. I think that should be fine still in terms of the time, since we can use the bomber as a shortcut, of course. And otherwise, I think we are still working on subjugating some of the systems. So this one we have successfully taken over last fight. And of course, morale is not looking so hot at the moment, but we are getting started on this here together with the puppet government. Otherwise, yeah, there's nothing to do except to terraform some planets, and this one is growing here, not as fast as it could do, because this is a mismatch in terms of the colonists, I should say. I think it does have an impact on the calculations, even though it's not really exposed anywhere, but at least they are pleased right now, thanks to all battles we have fought, even though it was against the Ferengi Alliance and what's left of it. Alrighty then. Okay, let's double check that we don't leave anything important here. So we have dispatched one bird of prey to find out what's going on over here, except for some Baron and Vex system here, completely scavenged by the Borg. Okay, puppet government. But we need a ship here, ideally, to to close the gap. Anything we could colonize, perhaps? Be brief. So this so they have wiped out the the minor race here, completely utterly wiped out every single soul. Oh, that's a little sad to be honest, so that leaves this open for grabs essentially, and I think we can actually colonize this right away, even though it is owned by the Ferengi right now, since we are at war. That's something we could make happen, perhaps. This is a Klingon sector. I think that is going by the color, so we should be able to intercept a couple of ships eventually, and they have to build another marauder over here. Must have purchased this outright. But at the moment, they only have two industrial bases left from what I can see. Three if you include Ferengi now, and we are moving in our SO transporters here. We are soon to take them out, I hope. And these are the remainders here of our attack on the Borg cube, which was moving in on Rabus, I believe. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then we will make a move on Ferengi now, probably. So, okay, then we can maybe try to see where the ships go, because they only have a range of one, and at least, well, where exactly? They won't go over here, probably. Can we please get that thing here out of the
purchase acknowledged?
And then we try to take this over here. Settle this immediately, build a. I mean, we should be able to build a wind turbine and set up a shipyard, even though the system has been completely wrecked. Well, I mean, it would work as an outpost, of course. So, a couple of raiders here, they're dispatching from their one industrial base they have left on this side. And yeah, we cannot go here, so we just wait this thing and try to intercept some ships here. Otherwise, we're just relying on the star bases, and that should be good for now. With two groups, and the cruiser is just hanging out here in the Entente system. One of their former members, actually. After, I'm not quite sure why they left the Federation, to be honest. Usually they don't do this in response to the Borg running rampant. Doesn't make a lot of sense to me. And the Vulcan are also at war with the Ferengi, so they must be over here in this little cluster we haven't discovered yet. And they usually also will build a couple of science vessels. They are not very powerful in combat, of course, but they have good scanners, and it's something to grab for the Klingon Empire and the Cardassians as well, since their destroyers are not equipped with good sensors, as we have learned. So two turns, we're already moving in on to Foygin up with them. Actually, then we have to soften up this a little bit here. We cannot engage these orbital batteries with these ships alone. They will be torn to pieces. Not to worry about a scout, of course. Okay, we will escort them into battle here, or into the system, and the other ones are incoming as well, so we have to see that they did not get intercepted here, but it's only one assault transporter, and then we have... okay, well then we can put some ships in here, I suppose, and the starboard should be plentiful to fend off these guys here. I'm worried about the ships at the moment. Okay, and hopefully they will be in position here finally to engage the system, and we should then also decloak and set our heavy cruisers on the orbital bombardment assignment, because the lighter ships will probably not survive the turn. Yeah, we can swap out some ships for damage control purposes, should be alright. Okay, otherwise I don't see anything we should be doing right now, so we just advance to the next turn. Yeah, enjoy that.
Our warriors are victorious.
Should be also auto-resolvable.
Our warriors are victorious.
Yeah, why though? I don't see how this would be necessary on their side. And yeah, so the Ferengi now one had in 46 credits, is quite good.
Yeah. Terraforming
can
completed.
Can get a little spammy if you are near many inhabited systems, evidently. Okay. The batteries, I don't think there's anything else to do with the system right now. It's fully functional, fully upgraded here. I think, well, we could maybe put this in here if we want to power it, but I don't think so. And wait, okay, the same goes for the training facility, because we're not going to put any ships here, most likely. Maybe purchase a couple in an emergency situation, but that's about it. Okay, and then get out of
purchase
here.
Acknowledged.
Afterwards, what do we want to do? We don't need, actually, class 5 is pretty decent, so we should probably staff these, even though we have some more opportunity. Still, I mean, it's getting better here, one bit at a time. Yeah, and just to make sure that they cannot grab this behind our lines here, of course. Really shouldn't happen, though. Maybe how many can we spare so we'll build? I don't know. Maybe just that one found we here and afterwards upgrade the entire thing. Yeah, Vader, enjoy that we have some star bases here. I mean, they could wait us if they want to, but okay. Now we should bring in our ships, and then hopefully we can converge on the system here before it's completely eradicated, but we may be too late since we can only move 2 tiles per turn. Yeah, quite unfortunate. So, another battlecruiser here to the mix, and in you go.
Task force will enter wormhole.
May actually be one of their colonies here nearby, but we do not share any intelligence with the Federation, apparently. Prey. I must be the newest colony we conquered from the Ferengi. Okay. From the build, queue empty. So it's another system we are building up to something here, supposedly. Okay, that first thing is we should put some of these minor buildings in here. Use the stuff together with the mining prison, probably. Always useful, especially if your economy is on the weaker side. Yeah, I'm really not sure why they accepted this. Maybe they figured they need time to recover, which is granted. It's that case, actually.
Select terraforming
so
target.
Too hard on them. So they have one router nearby, and we took out two more, so they must have purchased this outright here at the colony this very turn. Okay, so these guys can move over now, and then we should also decloak some of the ships we wanted to use in the orbital bombardment. Maybe just assemble so 8 cruisers or something here we can use right away. The heavy bot of bay we probably don't use for this purpose, so they can maybe intercept some people here if possible. Try to knock them out of orbit. It's also perfectly suitable for orbital bombardment. And we don't want to have too many ships flying at the same planet, because now we need to preserve as many structures as possible, because it takes a long time to get this up and running, of course. So, well, this can just stay here, I suppose, and try the intercept command. I don't think it works in the spirit space. No, it does not. But then we try this from our home base here, thanks to the starbase around. I think the starbase around, I should say. And this can just continue to wait, that's fine. And then kick out some of these later warships here, and hopefully we have enough. I just need to take these. Should also work. We can intercept right now, of course.
Just task force will raid enemy shipping.
So now for better cruises, and that should be a good night for them, I hope. I mean, we need at least one or two turns to destroy these batteries, but afterwards we should be able to invade the system with the combined might of our... how many do we have? I think it's 9 assault transports in total. That should be plentiful, and we have a couple more incoming here if we want to take them. Where are you going? So for the enemy system, that's not good, of course, but we're trying to chase them down here. No problem, I should hope so, at least. Just to make sure we put some in our path here of the assault transporters. It's a little stupid to make the move undefended here, you know, helpful enemy territory, but okay, we'll see. I'm not too worried about that one marauder, to be honest. Everyone else has their movement orders, okay. And yeah, one Vader. We cannot even park them in orbit to intercept these ships. It doesn't work, unfortunately, as we have learned. They will just sneak out of there regardless, which is a little strange, a little unfortunate, but yeah, it's an old clunky game for you. Also check our research here, that everything is so balanced that yeah, it went way out of WEC already, which is fantastic. After we do this, essentially. Yeah, but with all the war going on, I kind of lost track here of this stuff, to be honest. Let's set this to 10 for now. Okay, hopefully this will do the trick here finally. Alright, I think everything has been done, and let's see what the Federation is up to. I think they have destroyed all the ships fighting the Borg. This is why their military rating is very low right now. Yeah, I think it was at 30 or something, when we made contact, now it's down to 5. Yeah, and the reminder though, much of the information isn't guaranteed to be accurate since you don't have any intelligence arm to speak of. Fortunately, we did not intercept that marauder, as expected, so 62, and we're still based off here. So, okay, 3 turns, and the same goes for all of them, so hopefully we can convert to this position here finally. No, not the Borg cube. I mean, we will get there eventually. I'm interested in arriving in the correct sector. Yeah, 3 turns, we can only cross our fingers here that we arrive in time to help out our allies, and that apparently, yeah, so they can just move ships around here, no problem whatsoever, which is always nice, right? Okay, and over here we have more VEC systems, essentially. Okay, now we are in position and we should try to, take the system here, take out attacked. Some of these stupid orbital batteries. Hopefully not all of them are powered, but we cannot really tell from the orbit, of course. I mean, we should be able to, but it's really up to chance here.
System will be attacked.
And hopefully that will ensure that we don't take too much damage here in terms of casualties. Okay, and this is still class 3. Okay, so 2 turns, you can, or 2 tiles per turn, I should say. And the colony ship has been built, so then we can hopefully move over there together with some heavy ships here. But we should probably not leave them cloaked. We wanted to see if we can actually intercept some stuff here in disputed space. I don't think it was possible, and chasing down that marauder was an exercise in futility, of course. So, okay, 2 turns, and it cannot be intercepted. It could be intercepted, of course. I guess you can try to keep them safe here. We don't need the money pressingly. I mean, we do, kinda, but we can live with that little reduced income. So, 8 more trips, and all of them are unfortunately medium. I mean, most of them are. So, I think we explore some of these systems here since we have the starbase nearby and they can just keep in watch on the colony here, I suppose. It's not like I really want to hang on to this right now. It's only for advanced warning anyway. A little of scanner range, and even so we did not learn anything important since we have not discovered anything in particular. Okay, the ships can just stay in orbit here and we assemble a big group and move them where we want to, probably through the wormhole. Anything else should be good, but it's both over here. We brief just in case we forgot anything important. But this is still being upgraded. We can pause this if we want another ship built, it's okay. And some orbital factories, which is even fantastic, and then we can be afford a few more than that, but that would also be great. Okay, for more, I think should do that trick, and afterwards we upgrade. This is one of our most important industrial bases. Alright, hopefully we don't take catastrophic damage here, maybe lose a couple of battle cruisers. I mean, it could happen, we'll see. it's a pretty heavily defended system, but not nearly as close as Bajor, for instance, or Talar even. Yeah, it will be tough not to crack, even with all of the heavy ships here, and we don't have any dedicated strike cruisers for now. I'm not sure if we get any, maybe later on the tech tree could be. We could double check, of course, but for now we don't worry about it since it's phased off anyhow. Yeah, stupid.
Our warriors are victorious.
Okay, three ships and only, not even all destroyed here, which is fantastic. Okay.
Terraforming completed.
Let's see what it's looking like. So one more router they built here fresh, and they also try to assemble their little raiders into a formation capable of defeating some of us. Not quite sure what they took out. Probably these three battlecruisers. Okay, that's fantastic. Yeah, just lovely. Alrighty, wow. Then we have to build a couple more, I suppose. Yeah, but two. I think now we should, I think we should attack this before we take any more damage.
System
I think
will
we
be
can
attacked.
Afford to do so, since we have a couple more assault transporters incoming. And that's the double check, so this colony ship is closing in, and we need to provide support, of course. But it's doing its thing. Heavy bird of prey, and we have all the ships around here, so more better cruisers. Now, we try to hunt on a couple of ships, I guess. It's going to work, really. We just know that. We can make the attempt, that is. Assume that they move for some minutes. Okay, and nothing else over here. All this is to be expected. Colony ship can terraform
Select
our captured colony, and we have to take over every single system, or at least kill the entire population. This is a little excessive if you ask me, but it's just a game for you. No mercy, no quarter in all that. Okay, are we building only better cruisers? Okay, I think we put them some heavy cruisers as well to replenish our losses, and we're going to need them against the Cardassians pretty soon, I would imagine. Okay, well, we cannot really tell them to move out here. I don't think that's how this works. We can issue a statement, perhaps, but I think only the Ice Keeper is doing that, actually. Okay, so we're converting on their position. Maybe we engage them in a little fight there. Could also be. I mean, they wouldn't put it past us, since the relationship is already so low, you know. Okay, so we're off by two turns still, and I think the colony will hold on, but just for that long. Yeah, not a single turn after that, probably. Okay, but fingers crossed, hopefully we can vessel the home system from the Ferengi, and it will be a massive blow to their economy. Yeah, hopefully. Everything else seems to be alright for now, and hopefully don't lose any more ships, especially these heavy cruisers, because they are quite pricey. Well, we'll see. One command. This is okay, that's something we should direct him personally, perhaps. And finally, we have a tracked-down that marauder.
Where is our...
Yeah, there it is.
Near target practice.
Yes, sir.
Actually, don't charge them, we should strafe
our
them.
Weapon. This fight will be their last. Fire it will!
It's quite close as well.
They never stood a chance.
Okay, so I overestimated their force here, but the brawler is pretty good.
Another victory for the Empire!
Certainly no slouch there. Okay, two command, fire, first attack, I think it's auto resolve
it. Our warriors are victorious.
And there we go, we have taken it, and they destroyed two of the properties, assault transporters. Of course, they are, have to move in very close, of course, and we lost three assault transporters in total, along with another 31 million here in terms of population. Okay, and I think, yeah, it was 9 beforehand, so that's fantastic. And then we have another base here. Let's double check what they built. It must be pretty well upgraded already. So not class 4 at the moment, but we can lift that, I suppose. And yeah, we have to do this right away here after conquering the system. Plenty of food available for every single folk around here, every single living soul. Just max out what we can, and then power on some of these orbital batteries. Apparently we destroyed all of them, but it's a very nice boost here. And we also deprived the Ferengi Alliance of all their unique items, excuse me, the facilities, and we cannot build them ourselves, of course, but to be expected. I don't think you can build the puppet government on the home system, actually, for that matter. And indeed, I'm not seeing it here on the list, which is why we shouldn't bother with the mining prison right now, even though it would be quite nice. And we're looking at 54. Okay, so there's a pretty substantial risk of rebellion. So first things first, we set up our ship, yeah, probably, and then also build a starbase and a couple more replacement also transporters, since we're actually on the front lines and we could use them, by the way. And police state, well, that takes quite some time and we'll bring them up to 80, I believe, and that's an ongoing thing, you know. And we cannot really afford this at the moment, so that's something I can live with here, I suppose. So the home system has been taken over, and that should really ruin the morale, if nothing else. And yeah, we cannot take out Bezo. I mean, I'm not quite sure how many ships we would need, and lose for that matter, to take out these orbital batteries. And maybe we can do this through diplomacy, but I really doubt it. So we can maybe... yeah, maybe we can try this, but they will reject this probably, yeah. Most likely, okay. And that hopefully should also give us range for the other ships, and then we can at least take out these not well defended colonies here, wherever there may still be left. There can't be too many, of course. We're looking at Valbezo as a minor colony, of course. So one system with one planet each. Uninhabited, okay, this is not class M planet. And then that's something we can take over, by the way, along with the others. Well, we should even, since we are on the move here, we took out all the ships except for something they built here. Probably something they actually put over from, yeah, Talar. Okay, good for them. And for some reason, this system isn't fully populated right now, even though the Borg have not shown their faces around here, as far as I remember. Okay, then we move to the next sector. Which one should that be? We could probably take over all of them. Yeah, okay. Yeah, these ships... are still in decent enough shape, I suppose. I'm still missing a couple of heavy cruisers here, I'm pretty certain. Or at least a couple of battle cruisers. Yeah, but they are much stronger here, as you can see. And even so, we took some damage, but it's manageable. Now we need at least 4 transporters for every single system, even though they only have a handful of people living here, along with only one battery. It's not a guarantee that we can move past this, as we've learned over here, much to my dismay, yeah, was a little bit of a waste of industrial credits invested. I don't think it would, because it's north of the starbase, so it will still be just at one time, almost likely. But we should be aware of whether or not the Ferengi has expanded in this area. Because we are at war, and I think we should be able to gather information from this, since we have some ships buzzing around here with a couple of scanners, even though we have not discovered the systems ourselves yet. So, actually moving on. Class M planet, we're not sure what's down there, it could also be inhabited along with the other systems. So instead of moving, yeah, just do this here, see what's going on. These light warships, they can attempt to track down these elusive strategic cruisers. They can only move to here or there, so we just assume that they will use one of these systems here to reinforce it, if it's even inhabited. This one probably is, this one may not be. And we don't worry about the starbase, since we have another one nearby. We can fortify this later if we want to, or if we need to for that matter. Okay, well then we just get to work here, I suppose, clearing out some of these colonies. I'm not quite sure if we gained experience from orbital bombardment, probably not, but we have used the ship against a couple of Borg cubes at the very least, and we've also fought a pretty large Ferengi fleet at one point, so I think this will be the next to fall to our mind, since they have a shipyard over there, we know that much already. Yeah, we can be pretty certain about this. So we take all of our ships here so we don't lose anything, so these guys, they can just try to intercept some of these stragglers.
Will intercept all intruders.
This would work, since we have some light warships here instead. And that only leaves this option, but it's 2 turns away. So we try to intercept them here, I suppose. Because they have to move around here eventually, if they want to make a move, or interfere with ours, for that matter. These guys are still incoming. And then we have another 2 or so transports we could employ here, by the way, but not against the system, probably. But you can certainly dispatch them as reinforcements and then merge the formation once you have arrived. Plunge our losses and taking over one system will obviously use up at least one ship. Probably don't need as many ships down here, but we can decide later on and build up our formation. Yeah, should be decent. Nothing interesting, but it's a class M planet, the Cardassians haven't grabbed yet. How unusual of them. Maybe they also have trouble with rapid expansion, as with the other empires, whatever reason. I don't think it's down to the difficulty setting, from what I recall. So, yeah, that will be the last turn for them here closer. Let's double check that every single ship will arrive all at once, yeah. So we have, well, looks pretty decent to me. Well, except for the light ships, they probably won't survive, but we have a larger force than in the other battle. Okay, and well, the orbital batteries, they completely ignore Borg for whatever reason. It's kind of unfair when you think about it. Okay, we did not lose any ships, and we conquered Frigina, which is fantastic. Yeah, I sure hope it did. And you even get additional points here by taking over the home system of one of your rivals, yeah. Indeed, do. A massive one, we could probably check here. Yeah, so everyone is even loyal or at the very least pleased, well, almost, except for the Ferengi systems, unsurprisingly. They don't really like this, even if we do control them and have a puppet government in order. Okay. Now, fingers crossed, but I think we should be able to take on the Borg with our suffering, crippling casualties here. Yeah. I think this is one of the raiders.
Our warriors are victorious.
Yeah, there we go. This is something we want to direct manually, ideally. So we have 11 battlecruisers, 5 light bird of praise, maybe heavy one, and 10 heavy cruisers. Okay.
Resistance is futile.
Yeah, so these guys there will just hurry here to get some distance between them and the cube.
Our this
hopefully
fight
survive.
Will be their last.
They can just blast this thing here from afar. Near target practice? Is it a cocky man?
Fire at will!
Where are your shields now?
Well, the Borg won't have any shields, remember? Yeah, but we lose some ships here. I mean, we can set them to evade, but it doesn't keep them very safe against the beam weapons because the Borg employ very accurate ones, as you can think. Now, goodbye. They can fire at multiple ships at once, of course.
Another victory for
yeah,
the Empire.
Yeah, very important one, also the Federation. Oh, really? There's another fucking cube already.
Terraforming
are you kidding
completed.
Me with this?
We have news from our diplomats.
Man. Alright, then I really can't be bothered to continue the anti-Borg police route in this game, and to be honest, we have achieved all the objectives. It's just a matter of meeting these rather strict victory conditions, and well, the Ferengi are on their last legs. We've conquered the home system, and now it's just a matter of grinding our way through the rest of the Empire, thanks to the presence of about 30 or something orbital batteries, thanks to the minor races they have inherited through diplomacy, and what it will be a slogfest to be honest. And we have to bring in one ship after another, and it takes a long time, and so on and so forth. And the problems have been wiped out entirely anyway. So I think it's safe to declare victory and use this as a learning experience to plan our next campaign. And I will be quite intrigued to play a different faction, for instance, maybe with a smaller galaxy size and maybe a couple of other starting parameters. But it still has been a pretty exciting and interesting journey for me, and a pretty fun one as well. If you're getting reacquainted with the game and the various game mechanics, as well as the various quirks, yeah. But alright, that's an old clunky game, and I knew that much already going into this let's play. And yeah, I will be certainly playing more of this title probably pretty soon, so stay tuned for this. And if you've been following me along for this entire journey, then thank you very much for watching. And as usual, I hope to see you next time.